everyone, I am Rohit and welcome to my YouTube channel AI Era. In the previous video, we saw a two data exploration techniques, that is a pandas profiling and a sweet twist technique. Both a data exploration techniques will give a very good results. It will show a result or give a result in HTML format, or I can say it will create a report in HTML format. So, in today's particular video, I am going to discuss with you a new library called AutoViz. So, I can already explore more about that data exploration and exploratory data analysis. So, in this video, I am not going to talk more about how or what is need of data exploration techniques or what is its significance. So, if you want to more information about data exploration techniques or explorative data analysis, please refer my previous video. The link is below in description. So, in this particular video, we are go directly into Jupyter Notebook and see how the new library called AutoViz works. So, here I am in my Jupyter Notebook. So, I just simply write. So, you can see that for executing this particular library, it's only required only few lines of code. So I can measure it, that is only 1, 2, 3, 4. The 4 cell is required to execute this a particular library or get more intuition about this data. So first of all, we have to import or we have to install AutoViz library in our Anaconda module. Therefore, in Anaconda PowerShell prompt, we have to write pip install AutoViz. I can simply write pip install AutoViz, press enter. According to your internet speed, it will show you results. You all see over here, it shows me requirement already satisfied, because I am already installed my AutoViz module in my computer. So I can minimize it. The first step, I want to give a particular working directory. So by importing OS and by simply writing os.change directory, I can set my working directory as in E drive and in pandas folder. So I can press a shift enter, and here in square bracket it will come a number, the number 1. So it will represent this particular cell is get executed. The next step, I will import a AutoViz library. So for writing this a single line of code, that is from AutoViz.AutoViz_class import AutoViz class, and I can import AutoViz class in a variable called av, and I can press a shift enter. It will take a minute or more than minute to execute this cell. Okay, you can see over here the cell or my AutoViz library or my AutoViz class module is get successfully imported over here. Then without importing pandas, without importing numpy, we have to simply write this code, that is df is equal to, df is nothing but my data frame, and av is my AutoViz class. So simply we have to write df is equal to av.AutoViz, and in close parenthesis we have to mention our dataset. So from last video, I am using a same dataset, that is housing.csv, and in this particular video I am also using the same dataset called housing.csv, and I can press a shift enter. So it will take a time, probably it will take a minute. You can see over here it shows a asteroid. When my asteroid is get converted into number, then my this cell is get executed. It shows over here time required to run AutoViz a 19 seconds. So I will have to wait for 20 seconds. Okay, You can see over here. It shows a various scatter plot. Pairwise scatter plot for all continuous variables. So it shows scatter plot of between latitude and longitude, total bedroom versus longitude. And if you scroll down, you can get a better visualization of your dataset. But in this particular dataset or in this particular command, we did not mention our dependent variable. So what happens if we mention our dependent variable? So first of all, by simply writing df.head, we are taking a short look to our dataset. So particularly, my dataset is regarding housing price. So I can choose a dependent variable such as median house value. So I can just copy paste from over here. And simply write a small command over here, that is dep variable is equal to, and in quotation mark, median house value, and press a shift enter. Will show error. So here instead of small v, I have to write a capital V. Press a shift enter. So again, it will take a minute. We have to wait for a minute, and it will show a total time required to run at around 12 seconds. And you can see over here, it will plot a scatter plot against a dependent variable. You can see we choose a dependent variable, that is median house value, and on y-axis it shows a median house value with respect to longitude, median house value with respect to latitude, means it will plot each and every plot with respect to my dependent variable. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friend, and do subscribe my YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon and never miss an update. I already created a videos on pandas library and on NumPy library. To please visit my channel, that is called AI Era, and do access my all playlists in my channel. Thank you, one and all.